Adobe have updated Illustrator multiple times this year, and a lot of the new useful features might have actually flown completely under the radar to a lot of designers out there. Take this one for example right here. In the May 2023 update, we can now upload a raster image to Illustrator, and then if we come into the type window, we now see an option called retype. It's still in beta, so we have to take the results it gives with a tiny bit of caution. It's still really cool though, I promise. So essentially, this thing identifies possible fonts in flattened work or just raster images. The title of this design here is suggested to be Franklin Gothic. Oh, and by the way, the text that reads "This is Arial" is just placeholder text. But as you can see, we can cycle through the raster image that contains fonts that we like the look of, and then get some real-time possible suggestions for fonts. And if it's not an exact match, then we can get a close enough suggestion font-wise. And like I said, it also works on outline text and flattened work as well. So here, this is obviously Cadaver Grotesque, and by right-clicking it, I can outline the font just like that. Retype has matched it up to be Sculpin Regular, which is not, of course, but it is kind of close, I guess. But yeah, remember, this thing is still in beta mode, but the next tool today is fully flared and fully functional. Now, a huge part of working on graphics in Illustrator is that we often need to collaborate or share our work with clients, with other designers, or maybe you just want to spam it around social media like crazy. Well, now you can spam and share your work easier than ever before by coming into File and then Share for Review, or you can simply just click the Share button. People can even comment without an Adobe Illustrator account, which is pretty cool. You can name your link and control settings on who can see it and so forth. But there is a further update to this. Now we're able to control the amount of artboards we share from a single document. So we can share the whole lot of them, a range, or just a selection. Adobe Illustrator has finally gotten into the game of image generation. Well, not exactly image generation as such, but we do have a text-to-image sort of process in the new Illustrator update. Come into Edit, Edit Colors, and you will see another beta Adobe experiment, the Generative Recolor option. Now, I fully expect them to build upon this and improve it within time, but right now we can select a design and then type in the sort of color palettes that you want to work with. This is great if you know an emotion or a tone you want to express with your design, because then you can just quickly apply a color palette accordingly. Also, we can explore specific color systems such as complementary, monochromatic, and so on. This obviously has many different uses and it will save time as well as exploring different design avenues in your projects. Being able to use Adobe Illustrator is all well and good, but a huge part of getting your clients to say yes to your designs and getting more work from them is completely smashing the design pitch. That's where this awesome tool Walling steps into the limelight. Now, it's a visual tool for organizing your day-to-day life as a graphic designer and presenting your concepts or your designs, but it also helps you streamline your workflows and your processes with organizational tools such as notes, tables, schedules, and so on. And that's all smartly laid out with the ability to color code your walls. You gotta love that next level organization. Chef kiss. Also, walls and walling are optimized for phones, so that means your clients can view and interact with your walls on the go anywhere, anytime. Importantly, you can decide which wall sections to share with your clients or your colleagues, and then keep other sections totally private. But as I mentioned before, one of the main reasons why walling is so beneficial and useful to designers is the presentation pitch factor. This project right here has everything from the logo design itself down to the tone of the brand identity, and this would go down like a treat drawing the client pitch. You can start organizing your workflows, designing your best work, and pitching like a pro right now, today. And that's by heading over to Walling via the link in the description box below. I only ever talk about or work with brands on this channel that I feel are beneficial to graphic designers and I would actually use myself. And Walling, the sponsor of today's video, is no exception, so again, thanks to them. So here's some lovely bold paint splatter across an equally bold and captivating example of typography. With a new feature in Illustrator 2023, we can now have some fun with this in quick and real time. So come up to Object, Intertwine, and Make, and you'll find a few things with this tool that you should keep in mind. Firstly, when you hover your cursor over a selection, you can see a faint fill of the behind object. So you can then just go to town and highlight areas of the behind objects that you want to come to the front. This might take some time to experiment with, but you can make some pretty cool stuff in a matter of seconds or minutes. And of course, all vectorized. Now, a quick and a cool update that you might have missed is that when you come into the edit toolbar menu, as you hover your cursor over each tool, we can now see the label of the tool and also the corresponding keyboard shortcut. Let's face it though, that should have been there since day one, right? Also, as a side note, it's always really helpful to look down here at the bottom to know what kind of tool you're using at that present moment. This will help you know what shortcuts work with what tool, just in case you get lost. The next feature, or shall I say tool, has been given a huge Adobe facelift. I actually remember using the image trace tool back in around 2012, and back then it was super clunky and it was pretty much just a mess. It has improved over time, but we have some really useful additions to play around with in the recent updates. Now, the first one I really like is the ignore color option. If you remember, before we could only ignore white, but now we can choose to ignore any other color, which obviously just makes a whole lot of sense. Then another cool addition is that we can simplify the results here. And of course, this will be helpful in specific situations, not necessarily here with this eagle design. Weirdly enough, Adobe did give a redesign to the image trace window itself, and it looked like this in the previous update. But I updated AI to 27.8 today, which is the most recent update as of making this video. And the panel has reverted back to the old style of UI. Adobe probably has some kind of negative feedback to the new change, but still, the recent changes to the tool itself, the image trace tool, are pretty good. And Adobe Illustrator is a highly detailed, highly intricate design program, but if you want to learn things that most designers don't know about in this software, just click that video on screen. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.